Hello students, in previous class we discussed about the diffraction of the light. Let me discuss about Doppler effect in light. Doppler effect in light, what do you mean by the Doppler effect in light? So let us see what would be happening when a galaxy is moving away from the planet or towards the planet. What would be the changes takes place to the wavelength or frequency of the light? So depending upon that, we can estimate whether the galaxy is moving away or towards the planet. Let us say, if what is the apparent change in frequency? Apparent change in frequency of light, frequency or wavelength, or wavelength, which is delta nu by nu is equal to delta lambda by lambda, that is equal to V R by C. Then what do you mean by the V R? V R is nothing but radial velocity of the source. Radial velocity of source. Whereas C is what we know, speed of light in vacuum. Speed of light in vacuum. Is it? Now remember, if the wavelength increases, what happens to the frequency? Decreases. Because we know speed of light in vacuum remains constant. C is equal to V into R, V nu into lambda. Speed is equal to frequency into wavelength. Frequency into wavelength. Okay. Now let me take a negative sign. Why negative sign? Wavelength decreases, what happens to frequency? Increases. Is it okay? For the same constant, speed of light vacuum remains constant. Or even you can write delta lambda by lambda is equal to V R by C. If wavelength increases, then we will take it as positive. If the wavelength decreases, that will be taken as negative. Wavelength decreases means the object is moving towards the observer. If the galaxy moving away means it is a planet is a galaxy moving away, what happens? Then radial velocity vr moving away means what happens to the wavelength? Increases. It okay? Moving away means increases wavelength, but what happens to the frequency? Decreases. Frequency decreases. And this increase in the wavelength, so whenever it increases, whenever it is moving away, wavelength will increase. Wavelength increase means red light, which is only the longer wavelength can reach to the observer. So that we call it a red shift. Red shift. If the galaxy is moving towards, if it is moving towards the observer, then wavelength will be decreases, but the frequency will be increases. Wavelength decreases means towards the violet end, then we call it a blue shift. Blue shift. Is it? Similar as the limit of resolution and resolving powers of the microscopes or telescope. What do you mean by the limit of resolution? Limit of resolution means the minimum separation between the two point objects which can be observed distinctly is called. I have taken here two point objects. Can you distinguish these two point objects separately? May not be. Is it? But what would be the minimum distance between these two point objects to observe? Now can you observe? Yes, you can observe very clearly. That is what the minimum separation between the two point objects or two objects which can be observed distinctly are called, is called limit of resolution. Is it? Limit of resolution. For microscope, limit of resolution is equal to D minimum, which is equal to 1.22 lambda by 2n sin beta. Here, what do you mean by the beta n? Look at this one. We have the object of the microscope. The focal length of the object is less, whereas eye length is more. Here we will take the object. Object. Now, whatever we have the medium, if it is, if there is in a medium, and that medium refractive index is what? Yeah. Okay. So this is what refractive index of the medium. N is the refractive index of the medium. Beta is the semi vortex angle. Beta is the semi vortex angle. Whereas lambda is the wavelength of the light. Whatever we have used, wavelength of the light. So that the n sin beta is also called numerical aperture. N sin beta is called numerical aperture. Numerical aperture of a microscope. Object one. Whereas this is microscope limit of resolution. Then what about for telescope? Telescope. Then we have how can you increase the limit of resolution by using the lower refractive index by using the higher wavelength of the light. Then what do you mean by the for telescope limit of resolution is equal to 1.2 lambda by a. A is nothing but R D. D is nothing but diameter of the aperture of the lens. Diameter of the aperture of the lens. D is nothing but A. Diameter of the aperture. Diameter of aperture. Or size of the aperture. Aperture size of the aperture. Lambda is nothing but what? Wavelength. But actually, whenever we observe this on a screen, so when the light is passed this one, we will not get the exact point, but we have the diffraction effects. Due to the diffraction effects, the images will be obtained. And the radius of this one is 1.22 lambda f by d. So if it is walking this, that is what? Radius of the circular fringe. Similarly, resolving power is the reciprocal of the limit of resolution. Reciprocal of the limit of resolution is called resolving power. So that resolving power for microscope resolving power is what you get? 2n sin beta by 1.22 lambda. 2n sin beta by 1.22 lambda. Resolving power is equal to. Whereas for telescopes, reciprocal of the resolving power. Here what is resolving power? The limit of resolution 1.2 lambda. Then d by 1.22 lambda. Resolving power of this one. Now how can you increase the resolving power of the microscope? By using smaller wavelength of the light. Or by using higher refractive index of the medium, which is in front of the object. So these are what we have regarding this Doppler effect and limit of resolution of the limit of resolution and resolving power of the microscopes and telescopes. Let me discuss from material which is 35th one. What is given? A rocket is going away from the air at a speed of 10^6 meters second per second. Rocket. Which is nothing but radial velocity. Radial velocity is given, which is the rocket velocity. Vr is equal to 10^6 meters second per minus 1. If the wavelength of the light wave emitted by each is 5700 angstrom. Wavelength is equal to much? 5700 angstrom. What means Doppler shift? Doppler shift. Delta lambda by lambda is equal to Vr by C. So delta lambda is equal to Doppler shift. Doppler shift is equal to Vr by C into lambda. Then delta lambda Vr 10^6 by C is nothing but the speed of light vacuum, which is 3 × 10^8 into 10^-1 and wavelength 5700 angstrom. The answer also we get in angstrom. So here, what is it here? 10 power power minus 2, here 10 power 2, 10 power, then you will get 19. So 19 angstrom is a dark question. Similar as that, let us see that next one, 36 one. A rocket is going away from the earth at a speed of 0.2c. Vr is equal to 0.2c. So 0.2 times of the speed of light in vacuum. The wavelength of the light it emits a signal of frequency 4 into 10 power 7 hertz. So frequency nu is equal to 4 into 10 power minus 7 hertz. 4 into 10 power minus 7 hertz. Sorry, plus 7 hertz. What is the frequency observed by an observer on the earth? Frequency observed. Frequency observed. Tell me. What do you mean by the frequency, shifting frequency? Delta nu by nu is equal to Vr by C. Then delta nu is equal to Vr by C into nu is equal to initial frequency. Vr 0.2 C by C into frequency 0 by 4 into 10 power 7 H. C get cancelled. Then what you get here? 0.2 into 4, 0.8 into 10 power 7 H. But one thing you need to know that here what happened? Rocket is going away from the observer. Rocket is going away means what happens to the frequency? Decreases. Okay. Frequency will be decreased. Then nu dash minus nu is equal to 0.8 into 10 power 7 H. But you need to calculate, this is frequency decrease means nu minus nu dash. Initial minus final. Then nu dash is equal to nu minus this one. 0.8 into 10 power 7. Then initial frequency was 4 into 10 power 7 minus 0.8 into 10 power 7 is equal to 3.2 into 10 power 7 H. Remember here, rocket is moving away. Moving away. Moving away means frequency decreases. Wavelength increases, frequency decreases. That's what initial frequency more than final frequency. Therefore, frequency received by the observer is what? U dash. Let us see that 37th one. Aperture of your eye is 2 mm, A is equal to 2 mm, which is 2 into 10 power minus 3 meter. 2 into 10 power minus 3 meter. Assuming mean wavelength of light to be 5000 angstrom. Wavelength is given 5000 angstrom. 5000 angstrom means what? 5 into 10 power 7 angstrom. Is it? Sorry, meter. Angstrom is 10 power minus 10 into 10 power minus 3. The angular resolution limit of the eye is near B. So theta is equal to lambda by A. Lambda by A. Is it? So then you calculate what is value, substitute values and calculate. Theta is equal to lambda wavelength 5 into 10 power minus 7 by 2 into 10 power minus 3. Then 2.5 into 10 power minus 4 radian. But remember, options are given in terms of minute. Remember, 360 degrees equal to 2 pi radian. Then 1 radian is equal to what? 180 by pi degree. But 1 degree is equal to what you know? 60 minutes. Then 180 by pi into 60. That this value is radian. Therefore, theta is equal to 2.5 into 180 by pi into 60 into 10 power minus 3. This is what instead of radian we have to 180 by pi into 60. Pi value is nothing but 22 by 7 3.14, is it? Now let us see here 25, 60 into 25. 6 into 25 what? 150. 6 into 25 what? 150. So 15 into 18 by 3.14 into here 10 power 2, 10 power minus 4, 10 power minus 2. So that what will be here? Let us take it is 6, around 6, but not 6, still less than that one. 6 into 15, 19. So 19 into 10 power minus 2, 0.9 something you will get in minute. So which is approximately equal to what? 1 minute. Is it? From the given options, what do we have? What does we have? Second option. Is it? Similar, let us see. What is the fourth one? Two points separated by a distance of 0.1 millimeter can just be inspected on a microscope when light of wavelength 6000 angstrom. 6000 angstrom. Use pida which is a D minimum, minimum sub limit of resolution, how much is it? 0.1 millimeter. If the light of wavelength 4800 angstrom is used, then what will be the limit of resolution? Remember, what is formula for limit of resolution of the microscope? 1.22 lambda by 2m sine beta. So then our limit of resolution is directly proportional to wavelength. Then d2 by d1 is equal to lambda 2 by lambda 1, which is 4800 angstrom by the 6000 angstrom. Is it 10 6 86 and 4 2s 5 2s? 4 by 5 is nothing but what you know? 0.8. Then d2 is equal to 0.8 d1. That is equal to 0.8 into d1 is nothing but 0.1, which is 0.08 millimeter. This is first option. So this is what related to this limit of resolution and we have seen about the Doppler shift. So let us see polarization. What is the importance of the polarization? Polarization confirms the transverse nature of the light. It confirms that transverse nature of light. Transverse nature of light. Is it? Interference and diffraction not explained. What will be the nature of light? Is it a longitudinal or transverse? But polarization confirms the transverse nature of light. Remember, transverse waves can be polarized, but longitudinal waves cannot be polarized. That's what sound waves cannot be polarized. Sound waves cannot be polarized. Cannot be polarized, but light waves can be polarized because of those are transverse waves. Is it? And what do you mean by the polarization? Polarization means we have to restrict the light only in a single plane or in a single direction. When you have taken light, ordinary light means we already know about electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves means the combination of the electric field and magnetic field vectors which are vibrating perpendicular to each other and even perpendicular to the direction of the propagation. But remember, ordinary light means will take light vector, electric field. Light vector is nothing but electric field is the light vector. Why do you take this is electric field? Light vector means for all the properties of the light, only this electric field is responsible. Only the light field is the reason. That's what electric field vector is also called as what light vector. For alternate light, what is the symbol of the alternate light? Alternate light means the electric field vector can vibrate in all the directions, all around the direction, means in three directions. It okay? Whereas magnetic field for polarized light means whenever the light is vibrating in all directions, but we have to restrict that vibrations of the light vector only to a single plane. Whether it is in this plane or whether is it in a perpendicular to this plane, is it only to a single plane we have to restrict, and that property called as a polarization. So for alternate light, the symbol of the alternate light is electric field vector can vibrate in all directions. Is it okay? Can vibrate in all directions. Dot represents that light vector is vibrating perpendicular to the plane, whereas arrow represents that in the plane vibrating in all directions. Whereas polarized light means polarized means can take only to a single plane, or you can take like this. These are nothing but light is polarized in this plane. Here it is polarized in a plane perpendicular to the plane of the paper or plane of the board. Is it okay? Now what is the, how do we calculate, what do you mean by the polarized? Polarized of the devices which are used to get polarized light. Get polarized light. Polarized light. Get a polarized light. We use this polarized. What do you mean by polarized? Polarized are nothing but these consists of a long chain of molecules which are aligned in a particular direction. Aligned in molecules aligned in a particular direction. In a particular direction. Molecules aligned in particular. Now, whenever the light passes through this polaroid, what will happen? The electric field vectors in the direction of the alignment are observed. Then, the electric field vector can be polarized only in a direction perpendicular to the alignment of the molecules, which is called pass axis of the polaroid. Only along this axis can be vibrated, we call it as a polaroid, pass axis of these polaroids. Is it? Remember here, if you are taking electric field vector is along z axis, what do you call? If the direction of the propagation is x, then E z, if it is vibrating along z axis, then E z is equal to E naught into sine kx minus omega t. X is the direction of propagation, z is the vibrations of the electric field vector. Similar as magnetic field vector is nothing but what? B naught into sine kx minus omega t. Is it? Now you can observe. Direction of the propagation is x remains same. Okay. Here electric field vector is vibrating in z direction, whereas magnetic field vector is vibrating in y direction. Both are perpendicular to each other, even perpendicular to the x direction. Is it? Now the pass axis of the polaroid. Now let us see what would be the, what would be happening? How do you get the polarization? You can get the polarized light by the scattering, and even by reflection you can get, even by the refraction you can get, is it? And even by double refraction also can be obtained. So let us see some example. Polarization, is it? Nowadays we are using calculators, is it? Watches, display of watches, which are nothing but they are like a liquid crystals. Light polarized by the liquid crystals. That is due to the polarization of the light by the liquid crystals. LCD, liquid crystal display. So which is the polarization of the light. Is it okay? Now polarization by reflection. How do we get the polarization by the reflection? Whenever the light is incident on a boundary separating two media, here one medium. So here one medium, here second medium. First medium, second medium. Now, if the light is incident on this one, what would be happening? as the angle of incidence increases, angle of reflection also increases. Now, for particular angle of incidence, let us take IP, then the reflected light is completely plane polarized, but refracted ray is not completely polarized, partially polarized. Partially polarized, but it is what? Completely polarized. Which is completely polarized? Reflected ray is completely polarized. So that the angle of incidence for which reflected ray is completely polarized is called polarizing angle of Brewster's angle. Polarizing angle or Brewster's angle. And remember that one, a polarizing angle, reflected ray and refracted ray are perpendicular to each other. Angle between these two is nothing but what? They are perpendicular to each other. These two are perpendicular to each other. So that is, let me take here IP, and if it is R, then what is that? R and IP must be 90 degrees. From this one, Brewster has calculated the refractive index of the second medium corresponding to first medium, which is called Brewster's law. According to this Brewster's law, the refractive index of the second medium corresponding to first medium is equal to the tangent of the polarizing angle. Tangent of the polarizing angle, which is called this Brewster's law. Even you remember, mu is nothing but, okay, right? Refractive index of the medium is nothing but 1 by sin c in terms of the critical angle. 1 by sin c is equal to tan ip. Ip, p is nothing but what? Polarizing angle or Brewster's angle. Then c is equal to sin inverse 1 by tan ip. And even, let me discuss about how to get the reflected light by using the polarizer. So when you have taken a polaroid, pass axis of the polaroid, pass axis of the polaroid given. Now the ordinary light is incident on this polaroid. Ordinary light is incident. Remember, if the intensity of the incident light is I0, then half of the light is polarized. That is, half of the light gets polarized. Half of the light will be polarized. But to get completely plane polarized light, we have to take one more polaroid, which is called analyzer. This is polarizer, and it is called analyzer. Is it okay? Now the transmitted light, intensity of the transmitted light is I0 by 2 into cos square theta. I0 by 2 means the light ray which is incident on this analyzer. Now theta is nothing but angle between the pass axis of the polaroids P1 and P2. Theta is nothing but angle between polaroids P1 and P2. And this is also called what? Marvel's law. According to Marvel's law, the intensity of the transmitted light is directly proportional to the square of the cosine angle between the two polaroids. Even you have to understand that if the electric field vector is vibrating with E, then it is cos theta, the amplitude is A. Then what do we get here? A cos theta and A sin theta. Only due to this will get electric field. Now if theta is equal to 0, we get maximum intensity of the transmitted light. If it is 90, we will get the maximum intensity of light is what? 90 means 0, transmitted light is 0, completely 0. But if it is 1 or 180 degrees, angle between these polarized 1 or theta equal to 0 or 180 degrees, the transmitted light will be almost 1. Now here, what is intensity of the light? When you have taken one polaroid, I not by 2, what is the intensity of light which does not polarize? Remaining moments, I not by 2 is not polarized. That I not by 2 can be polarized by using second fluoride. Okay. And remember, even by rotating this without having first, second polaroid ELISA, even if you rotate this P1, nothing will be happening. The intensity will be remain synonymic. But we then we have taken P1 and P2, and if you rotate those two, then you will get polarization, intensity of transmitted light is different. Even by refraction also we can get, when you have taken Bartholomew has given, whenever the light is passed through this crystals and it will be refracted into two, one is ordinary and it is extraordinary. Light can be one. Like when you, for this crystal, if you have observed this spot, ink spot, you can get two images. One is due to the ordinary light ray which is fixed, and another spot is due to the extraordinary light ray which is rotating. When you rotate this crystal, that the spot which will get due to the extraordinary ray, it will rotate around this one more spot, which is the by double refraction. Even by refraction also can get this polarization by scattering. Whatever the light we are getting from the sun, that is due to scattering, this also can be obtained by the polarization. Can we can get the polarized light due to this also. Refraction means when you have taken number of slides which are aligned with particular angles, you get the polarized light. Intensity of transmitted light is different, completely plane polarized light. And that is for glass it is 7 and for water it is around 53 degree angle of polarization, roaster side. Is it? So let us see example based on this polarization. Now see, let us see 38 one. When the angle of incidence is 60 degree on the surface of the glass slab, it is found that the refracted ray is completely polarized. The velocity of the light in glass. Tell me, what do you call this angle? Polarizing angle or Brewster's angle? Because at polarizing angle, the refracted ray is completely plane polarized. So for Brewster's law, what do you know? Refraction index is equal to tangent of the polarizing angle. So then what we get right here? They are asking to find the velocity of light in glass. Tell me, what do you mean by the refraction rate? Speed of light in glass is by speed of light in glass, which is equal to tan 60. Tan 60 value is what? 1 by root 3. Then Vz is equal to C by tan 60. Tell me, what is C value? 3 into 10 power 8 by 3 into 10 power 8 by what is tan 60 value? 1 by root 3. 1 by root 3. Sorry, root 3. Is it? So what do you get here? Root 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Root 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second measurement, which is second option. 39. Unpolarized light is incident on a dielectric of refractive index root 3. What is the angle of incidence? If the refracted beam is completely polarized. Here what is given? Refractive index is given and asking angle of incidence, which is nothing but polarizing angle. Root 3 is equal to tan 80, then IP is equal to what again? 60. Tan 60 root 3, same as this one, reverse. What is given? An unpolarized beam of intensity 2A square passes through a thick polaroid. Assuming zero absorption in the polaroid, the intensity of emergent plane polarized light is. Intensity of emergent polaroid. Look at this one. We have a single polaroid. Is it? Now, intensity of light is what? Here, 2A square. So 2A square is passes through this one. But here what is intensity of this light? I is equal to I naught by 2. Half of light gets polarized. That is equal to 2A square by 2 is equal to what? A square, which is second option. What is first? When unpolarized light beam is incident from A onto the glass, the polarizing angle. Is it polarizing angle they are asking? What a reflected beam is 100% polarized, and reflected and refracted beams are partially polarized. Remember, they given polarizing angle. At polarizing, what do you know? At polarizing angle, the light reflected ray is completely plane polarized. Is it? Reflected ray is completely plane polarized. So that first option is correct one. Let us see what is second one. The critical angle of a certain medium is sin inverse 3/5. Critical angle. Critical angle C is equal to sin inverse 3/5. Sin inverse 3/5. The polarizing angle of the medium. Polarizing angle of the medium. Polarizing angle of medium. Look at this one. What is this value? Sin C is equal to what you know? Sin C is equal to what here? 3/5. But remember, what is refractive index is equal to what? 1/sin C, which is 5/3. But remember, from Brewster's law, what is refractive index is equal to tangent of the polarizing angle. Tangent of the polarizing angle. But you need to find here polarizing angle. I is equal to mu is what here? 5/3 is equal to tan IP. IP or IB, Brewster's angle or polarizing angle. Therefore, IP polarizing angle is equal to tan inverse 5/3. Tan inverse 5/3, second option. 43rd one. When an unpolarized light of intensity I naught is incident on a polarizing sheet, intensity of light which does not get transmitted is. Look at this one. I naught by 2 is polarized. Then what is, which is not polarized remaining? I naught by 2 is remaining. Not, does not polarize, does not transmit it. Only I naught by 2 is transmitted. So that option is what? I naught by 2. Let us see 44th one completed. 45th one. To increase both the resolving power and magnifying power of a telescope. Resolving power and magnifying power. Look at this one. Telescope. What is the resolving power of the telescope? Resolving power of the telescope. Is it? D by 1.22 lambda. Whereas magnifying power of the telescope what? Magnifying power of the telescope F naught by FE. Is it? For a value. Now what am I asking? How can you increase? The focal length of the object has to be increased. Focal length of the object has to be increased. Okay? Both focal length and aperture of the object lens has to be increased. Yes. By increasing the object focal length, you can increase magnification. Even by increasing aperture also can increase the resolving power. Is it okay? Therefore, second option is correct. 46th one. The graph showing dependence of intensity of transmitted light on the angle theta between the polarizer and analyzer. Dependence of intensity of transmitted light. What is intensity of transmitted light? Intensity of the transmitted light. Okay, let me write. I is equal to I naught by 2 cos square theta. Is it okay? Now, at theta is equal to 0, what is I value? Maximum I naught by 2. Okay, whereas at theta is equal to 0 or 180 degrees. Whereas for 90 degrees, what is it? I is equal to 90 degrees 0. Now, let me draw the graph for intensity and angle. Intensity I and it is theta angle. At 0, what is this one? I equal to 0. 90. And, okay, 45, 90, 135, 180. 180. So remember, at theta is equal to 0 at 180, intensity is maximum. At this point it is maximum. At this point it is. But at theta is equal to 90 degrees, what happens? Intensity will be decreases. 0. Almost it is 0. At 0. But at theta is equal to 45 degrees, what is it here? Cos 45. 1 by 2 whole square. 1 by 2. I naught by 2. I naught by 2. So I naught by 2, I naught by 4, is it? I naught by 4, I naught by 2, 3 I naught by 4 and so on. So at this point, here how much is it? I naught by 4. At 135 also I naught by 4. Then what is it here? Like this will be. Approximately will have it. Then which option is correct? Fourth option is correct. Fourth option is correct. But in options it is given, I think, what is this one? Third option? Third option is not correct one. Fourth option is correct. Let us see, which of the following diagrams represent the variation of electric field vector with the time for a circularly polarized? Circularly polarized means Ex is equal to E cos theta, Ey is equal to E sin theta. Ex is equal to E cos theta, Ey is equal to what? E sin theta. And then what is E root over? E square. That is equal to what? E, which is remains what? Resultant is remains constant, does not depend upon time. Then first option is correct one. Is it? So this is what wave optics, and we have seen already ray optics has finished and wave optics has done. Is it? You need to go through the textbook and thereafter you refer any objective material by following these classes, so that definitely you can get the knowledge to solve the bits or to solve the conceptual based questions also. Is it? I think tomorrow we'll be having test based on this ray optics and wave optics together, which is for 60 marks. Please attempt that exam and you check the answers. After that one, key will be sending to that, and thereafter just try to analyze the answers and which is the solutions also will be, if it is needed, the solutions also will be sent to you. Thank you. All the best.